I'm Sheriff Rick Bradshaw. Thank you for joining us for this episode of Behind the Star.
Thanks, Sheriff Bradshaw. Here at the Palm Beach Sheriff's Office, this holiday season is all about service and celebration. First and foremost, we want everyone to know that our deputies pledge to protect and serve. Here at PBSO, we work hard to make sure the residents of Palm Beach County stay safe. The holidays are a busy time for traveling and visiting family and friends. We ask everyone to play it safe on our roads. Please make sure you buckle up, get enough sleep before driving, do not drink and drive, and never text or spend time looking at your phone while driving. Let's work together and play it safe this holiday season. And we want to emphasize defensive driving. This picture has some fun with cobwebs on a turn signal. We're seeing fewer people use their left and right blinkers, but we want to emphasize the importance of safe driving, which includes the proper use of turn signals. Recently, PBSO observed Crash Responder Safety Week. It's a time to honor the men and women who are first on the scene of an accident. Those who serve to keep us safe during difficult moments also deserve to go home at the end of the day. If you see a responder on the side of the road, make sure to slow down or switch lanes safely. Unfortunately, we see too many crashes after an initial accident. If you're involved in a traffic accident, follow these steps. Number one, put on your hazard lights and pull over. Then call 911, even if the crash isn't critical. If it's safe, get out of your car and check on others. The Palm Beach Sheriff's Office observed National Child Safety and Protection Month. Did you know 9.2 million children annually visit an emergency department for an unintentional injury? We urge everyone to play it safe. And this holiday season, we want to remind you to make sure your alarm company has your six-digit permit number. This is required for law enforcement to respond to an alarm call. We all know this is a busy time of year for shopping. Many of you will fill the wish list of friends and family by making your purchases online. And for those shoppers, we offer the following tips.
Online shopping has never been more popular. That's why the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office wants you to take the following precautions while making purchases on your computer, like ensuring you're using a browser with a secure connection. How do you know it's secure? Just look for the padlock in the address bar. If you're buying or selling online locally, meet in a public area for the transaction and bring a friend along for safety. Always pay with a credit card instead of a debit card. You can dispute a charge using both payment methods, but with a debit card, it may take weeks before your money is returned. And finally, keep receipts and know a retailer's return policy. The Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office says if online shoppers use common sense, they will make some net gains this holiday season.
There's also a concern after the purchase has been made and the package is just sitting on your porch. Nearly 1 in 5 Americans are the victims of package theft, and the numbers increase during this time of year.
Five Americans are victims of package thefts, and the numbers increase during this time of year. These porch pirates know when you receive your online purchases in the mail. Here are a few tips you could use to stop these opportunistic thieves. Track your package. Make sure someone is home to receive the package. Opt for having the package be signed on delivery or schedule a pickup instead. You could also ask your mailman to place packages in less visible places if you're not home, like behind some furniture or around a bush. Install a real-time security camera that alerts your smartphone, tablet, or computer when there are trespassers surrounding your property. This allows you to stop the crime or alert authorities right away. Lastly, if you see something, say something. Download the PBSO mobile app, which allows you to report any suspicious activity anonymously.
If you're doing some traditional shopping at a store, we offer these 12 tips this holiday season.
The holidays are here, and so is an increase in retail crime. To fight those Scrooges, the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office offers the 12 Tips of Christmas. Number 12, don't leave gifts like 5 golden rings visible in your car. 11, park your car near other vehicles in a well-lit area. 10, always lock the car. Number 9, shop with friends or family, there's safety in numbers. At 8, women should carry their purses across their chests. 7, men should keep their wallet in a front pocket. 6, never flash your cash at the register. At 5, take paid merchandise into the fitting room. 4, stay off the cell phone and be aware of your surroundings. 3, especially in busy stores, keep an eye on kids. At number 2, when walking back to the car, make sure you are not being followed. And number 1, go straight home after making big purchases. 12 tips from the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office to ensure you have a happy holidays.
And now on Behind the Star, we want to honor local veterans. Recently, PBSO participated in Veterans Day parades around our county. And Sheriff Rick Bradshaw and the entire PBSO family honor the dedication and bravery of our nation's veterans. We are forever thankful for their sacrifice.
So let us honor these brave men and women who have always fought for our safety, security, and prosperity. As a former Marine, I want to say Happy Veterans Day to all my brothers and sisters. Thank you. Thank you.
it is with great sadness that we announce the passing of retired Lieutenant Jeffrey Nicholas. He served PBSO honorably and with distinction from 1979 to 2004. Let's keep the Nicholas family in our hearts, thoughts, and prayers during this difficult time. And we honor Lori Van Dusen Van Reet. Lori recently passed away at the age of 71. She became only the second uniformed female police officer at the West Palm Beach Police Department. She later became the Special Projects Coordinator on Firearms with PBSO. Lori was a pioneer in Palm Beach County with her use of crime gun intelligence to help solve violent crimes. Our thoughts and prayers go out to her friends and family.
So today we're here to talk about securing your home while you're gone on vacation or out of town so that it is not a opportune target for burglars and thieves. Well, if you're going to leave on a vacation, you're going to be out of town for any length of time, you want to make sure that you make your home look like you are still there. Some of the ways that you can do that are to make sure that when you're gone, someone continues to cut your grass. Keep the house outside look like someone's still there. Part of that would also be if you get newspaper delivery to either stop the delivery or have your neighbors or someone pick up the newspaper and bring it in or put it out of sight so that people driving by couldn't tell that there was an accumulation of newspapers in the driveway. Along those lines also goes with your mail. Either have your mail delivery stopped or have neighbors pick up your mail. Get the automatic timers for your lights, which will turn your lights on and off at night while you are away so that it looks like there's activity in the home. One of the other things that you do, especially in this day and age with the prevalence of social media, is you don't want to post on social media that you're going on vacation, because sadly to say, sometimes burglars aren't going to be people that you don't know. They could actually be someone on your friends list. Have secure door locks on your home. And if you have an alarm, make sure you set your alarm and have that monitored. I think most alarm companies, you can call them and let them know that you're going to be on vacation. So if the alarm is activated, that they know you're not there. Some of the other things that you can do are video surveillance cameras. Make sure everything in your house that's of value is secured. When you're out of town, have your neighbors look out for your home. The bottom line is you just want to make it as hard as you possibly can for the burglar to A, get in your house, and then B, if they do get in your house, to get your stuff and steal it. PBSO wants to make sure that when you leave on vacation and you come back, that your house is just the way it was when you left it.
Welcome back to Behind the Star. Palm Beach County residents, we want you to know this is what homelessness looks like in our county. In this season of giving, reflection, and gratitude, let's be mindful of others. Together, we can make a difference. If you'd like to help PBSO's homeless outreach team, send us an email at homelesshelp@pbso.org.
Please, take us to the annex center. Please. Please. And now we gotta weather this storm out, and I'm trying to figure out what to do. And I'm not gonna leave this man. Not. Please do it. Thank you so much, sir. I appreciate the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Department very much. The officer came by during the hurricane and helped more than I could say. And I appreciate my friend coming to get us. And I thank him for everything. Palm Beach County, you're awesome.
Recently, our homeless outreach team came across Jessica, a single mother and her four children. They've been living out of a van. The team was able to assist the family by providing them with temporary shelter at a hotel and taking them out shopping for necessities. Jessica was beyond thankful that PBSO was there to help in her time of need. PBSO would like to send the community in Chesapeake, Virginia, our thoughts and prayers after a tragic mass shooting at a Walmart. We're also thinking of the three victims who were shot and killed at the University of Virginia's main campus. We remind everyone to please alert us if you see anything suspicious. We are one phone call away. Together, we can avoid catastrophes before the holidays. Our detectives are going to schools in Palm Beach County, educating students on what to do to prevent mass violence.
My name is Detective Silvestri. I'm a detective with the Targeted Violence Unit. So we've been going to all the charter schools and private schools in the county so far, trying to educate all the students to say something if they see something.
Every time there were people that saw signs, right? Warning signs that this person was capable or was going to do a mass violence incident. Who's going to see these warning signs in fellow students? It's not going to be us. It's going to be you guys.
The term school shooting is a very strong and sensitive phrase, right? But unfortunately, it's happening. It's happening in our backyards. It's happening nationally. It's happening locally. So that's why we're here, to spread awareness to try to prevent this. Right, because I don't know about you guys, but I get sick and tired every day when I wake up and I turn on the news and there's an incident of mass shooting at a school where multiple lives were lost.
Here at PBSO, we worked hard to make sure everyone had a great Thanksgiving. At New Birth Deliverance Baptist Church in Belleglade, cars lined up for a drive-through turkey giveaway, where 1,300 turkeys and 200 hams were handed out. PBSO also spent a morning in Mangonia Park to help others celebrate Thanksgiving. The recipe for a happy turkey day? Spreading kindness, spending time with loved ones, and sharing gratitude with others. PBSO also partnered with the Susan Solano Foundation to distribute over 900 turkeys to families in the Glades region. With the help of city officials, 450 turkeys were distributed to community members at Tanner Park in South Bay. The other 450 turkeys were distributed in the city of Pahokee at MLK Park. Thanks to everyone who made a donation to allow us the chance to put together Thanksgiving meal gift bags. Your gift helped a lot of families have a bountiful Thanksgiving. During the entire week of Thanksgiving, we expressed our gratitude to the many organizations that allowed us to give back to our community. We thank these groups for donating and volunteering so we can make sure everyone had a Thanksgiving meal. And finally, let's leave you with a couple of Thanksgiving messages from Sheriff Rick Bradshaw and the men and women who protect and serve.
This is Sheriff Rick Bradshaw with a Thanksgiving message. Thanksgiving is the perfect time to reflect on and honor the sacrifices that you and other members of the agency have made in order to steer our agency to new heights. We are tremendously thankful to you for that. Wishing you a very happy Thanksgiving.
How did this happen? What if he really didn't mean it?
I'm sorry.
I don't even have money. Where am I gonna go? What will people say? I'm so stupid. My family loves him.
Shut up!
What about my son?
You cannot take my son away from me.
You know I do this because I love him.
I shouldn't have fallen. But nobody knows.
I'm just trying to protect you.
Was it my fault? Where am I gonna go?
Why did you get me so mad?
He's always gonna find me.
Where are you gonna go?
Who else will love me?
You can never leave me.
I shouldn't have gotten him mad. I'm so stupid.
It's my fault.
Do. I have no one else. Who do I tell?
I'll kill myself.
Who do I tell?
I'll find you.
Find you.
I need to get out of this. I need to get help.
And now, some news and notes from around the Palm Beach Sheriff's Office. The men and women of PBSO worked hard to ensure the safety of our residents during Hurricane Nicole. Nicole was the 14th named storm and the 8th hurricane of the 2022 Atlantic hurricane season that thankfully ended November 30th. After Nicole left our area, we assessed the damage and made sure our roads were clear. If you're looking to end the year with a new job, we're hiring. We're looking for a benefits analyst. Visit pbso.org/jobs for more information. We've started PBSO's LEGOs mentoring program at Green Acres Elementary. The mission of this program is to interact with children from the community, to talk with them about the harmful effects of bullying and participating in gangs. Don't be fooled by the cuteness of this dog. Our PBSO canines are always ready to serve and protect Palm Beach County. Join us in welcoming Jack, who will work with patrol and explosives detection. There's also another new canine deputy in town. We introduce you to Coco, a lab shepherd mix who will serve the community in Palm Beach County by working in search and rescue. For those interested in sponsoring a canine, contact the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Foundation. PBSO's volunteering program was established in 1989, and the program has grown to nearly 1,500 members. Our volunteers serve in many capacities throughout the agency, such as emergency response, the Marine Unit, special events, and others. For more information, email volunteer@pbso.org. Recently, we had a very impressive visitor join us at our Lake Worth Beach station. Julian told his grandmother that he wants to have a future in law enforcement, so she suggested they stop by. We love the visit, and we look forward to him joining the team one day. We love hearing from residents, like the family of this little girl who wrote, "Scarlett loved her visit. She got a tour by Deputy Lutz, a badge was given to her, and she also received a stuffed puppy. Thank you." And now, a love story in the middle of Hurricane Ian relief efforts. PBSO Deputy Yannick Exias and her husband, Officer Glenn Finlay from the Opa-locka Police Department, were both helping out on the West Coast. While there, Officer Finlay found a way to surprise his wife for their second anniversary. Congratulations! PBSO deputies chatted with the residents of Western Lantana during another Conversation with a Deputy event. Thanks to Jupiter Donuts on Lantana Road for hosting and for the amazing treats. Our mounted unit was honored to represent PBSO at the World Polo Championship opening ceremony. This is the second time the international contest has taken place in the United States, so we wanted to impress our guests. And finally, we leave you with a special song from Brian Nandlal. He's the son of Sergeant Ramesh Nandlal and a very talented singer. This song goes out to all the brave men and women who leave their homes and families to protect and serve during this holiday season. We want to thank you for watching, and on behalf of everyone at the Palm Beach Sheriff's Office, we wish you happy holidays.
Now I've heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah, hallelujah. You say I took the name in vain. I don't even know the name. But if I did, well,
be
really
safe.
What's it to you? There's a blaze of light in every word. It doesn't matter what you heard. The holy or the broken heart. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I did my best, it wasn't much. I couldn't feel, so I tried to touch. I've told the truth, I didn't come to fool ya. And even though it all went wrong, I'll stand before the Lord of Song with nothing on my tongue but hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Okay, that'll do it for this episode of Behind the Star. On behalf of the men and women of the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office, thank you for watching.